Thank you for coming this morning. Isn't this a wonderful day?
Yeah.
I know most of you don't remember January 5th, 1995, but I want you to remember that day, because that day was the day of the flood, the 200-year flood which happened in Southern California. And I know some of you did have damage to your apartments and to your home, but we're very fortunate, very lucky, that none of our residents suffered any major injury or loss of major property. One of the Golden Rain Foundation property which was severely damaged was the healthcare center building, along with your apartments and also the amphitheater. On that day, the Golden Rain Foundation Board of Directors, with the help of many, many volunteers, began the process of looking into the possibility of having a healthcare center building which would not be flooded, at least, and would have no roof leaks, and would have no air conditioning problems, and above all, would provide convenience and comfort for our residents who decide to use the healthcare center. The Golden Rain Board began to look into the possibility of fixing the building or consider rebuilding a new building. It took almost 2 years for that debate and for that discussion. And yes, there were some people who expressed an opinion that we do neither, not fix the building or not replace the building. Then some people thought, yes, we should repair the building. And others thought we should rebuild the building. Well, October 17th, 1995, Golden Rain Foundation did take the first step of starting the process of rebuilding a brand new building. And then debate and discussion again began, who's going to pay for it? And who's going to own that building? And a lot of people thought, you know, that I was going to own that building. 2 years of wrangling and open meetings and discussions with all of the shareholders, on May the 6th, 1997, Golden Rain Foundation Board voted to start the project and give the contract to the company to build a brand new building for the residents of Leisure World. Well, some of the questions were indeed answered. Let me just review those with you. Who owns the building? I don't, My wife doesn't. My children don't own it. But you, as the shareholders of the Mutual Corporation and the Golden Rain Foundation, collectively own this building free and clear of any debts. We did not go out and borrow the money for this building. We did use the existing reserve funds created by the Golden Rain Foundation for many, many years of planning for replacing this building. And today is the day that you can really see that the vision of many of the directors and the vision of many of the residents, the staff, and numerous other groups of people who supported this project has indeed realized this morning. Once you go inside this building, you will be able to see what this building has to offer you if you need to use the services of the pharmacy or the healthcare center for the lab work, or you want to go see your doctors, or just want to go in because you will feel like just going in there. It is wonderful inside. And we have completed this project without any increase to your monthly charges. In fact, not only that it talks about increasing your charges, it is going to give you more revenues. We have negotiated a contract whereby the rent is substantially more than what it's been in the past. And still, the Golden Rain Foundation members and shareholders own this building along with all of the other buildings in the community. You are the owners of this building, and be very proud of it, because we have the vision now that you look forward to the year 2000. I hope some of you will remember when you were going and visiting your doctors in those temporary quarters in the back. And some of you remember in 1995 when we transferred the healthcare center to the clubhouse number 3. And some of you still remember, we still have that small building sitting there which would be demolished in the next 2 or 3 months. And we will indeed have more parking for you to use when you come and visit this facility. You know, during these months and years of negotiation and discussions, I can name so many directors who had the vision and the desire to take literally the abuse from many who thought that this project was not feasible or possible. But one person for the last 2 years who has worked very closely with me, and she has been so supportive of this project along with so many other directors. And she's here this morning among us, and I want her to come forward and share with you what her view is. And would you please all welcome Mrs. Mildred Tuttle, the president of the Golden Rain Foundation Board of Directors.
Thank you, Mr. Narang. Good morning. I'm happy and privileged to be here today to welcome all of you to this brand new building, our official opening. We have so many individuals to thank for this. We have all those residents who have supported us from the very beginning, who understood how great our need was for a new facility. And we have to thank all the volunteers who worked at the health center to keep it functioning well during the period of construction. And thanks to those individuals who put up with the problems of a cutback in our parking spaces during construction. They are the residents who use the pool, who visited the administration building in Clubhouse 5, and who came for health care. And yes, even the golfers, many of whom found somewhere else to park. And we must not forget the residents of Mutual 5, who live so close to the activity and had to live with the noise and the dirt created during construction, and who still have to hang in there during the demolition of the other portion of the original building. We've built this building without raising the GRF assessments to the residents. And please remember, this beautiful building belongs to the residents.
And we're here this morning also. And I want him to come forward and at least share with you what his vision is now and how he sees this project benefiting the residents of Leisure World. Would you please welcome Tom Barrett, Chairman of the Medical Committee.
I'm very fortunate this morning. I get a chance to talk about it at the good end of it, and Mrs. Burns got a chance to do all the hard work to get it started. But we have a new building now, which is ready for will become a trite stain, get us ready for the next century, which will last for a long time to come. But you know what's interesting? As you look across the way at the old building, it's really amazing that it lasted 35 years. When you look at all the changes in medicine that have happened since 1962, it's amazing that that building stood there this long. Mr. Narang talked about air conditioning, about heat, but they're also, it's amazing how the staff kept it going with electrical problems. And so really, it's a credit to the staff that we've managed to keep that building 35 years. And let's hope they enjoy this new building. And there's one more thing that happens with the opening of the new building. After a year and a half of negotiations, we now have provided a plan, Blue Cross Prudent Provider, which will permit people under 65 to have a program which will give them care here. So now we have a facility, a new facility, which is able to be used by the entire community. Thank you very much for coming.
I'm very happy this morning that we have some of those officials here this morning, and I want to welcome our county supervisor, and we all want to extend him our congratulations because he's just scored a great victory to be our county supervisor. He is the man who has been helpful in every aspect when we need things done, either through the county, through the state, and many times even with the federal government, he assists us finding us who we can get in touch with. He's our county supervisor, Mr. Jim Silva, and his mom lives here too. I want you to know that.
Thank you, Bill, for inviting me here today. It was 4 years ago that I was elected, November of 94, to the Orange County Board of Supervisors. And in December, and actually it was December 6th of 1994, before I took office, Orange County declared bankruptcy. And I thought, oh my gosh, what am I getting into? The newspaper said, what do you think about that? And I said, I think I'd like a recount. Then, I believe it was Thursday before I took office, it was about December 30th, my first day at the county office, my secretary didn't show up. And I called her home about every hour during the day. And finally at 6 o'clock, I called the sheriff's substation close to her home and I said, would you please check on her? Well, about 2 hours later, Brad Gates called and he said, I have some very bad news. We have two deputies are coming out to talk to you. Well, at that time I found out that my secretary had been murdered in her home. Then I was sworn in on January the 5th, and I'm very excited to be the county supervisor, 10 o'clock in the morning, and all of a sudden it was 9 o'clock at night, and I didn't realize, you know, that they had just disappeared, and the sheriff walked into my office and he said, Jim, he said, I've got good news for you. And I said, well, I need some good news. He said, I have a way that you can get home tonight. And I said, why? He said, well, your roads are flooded out in Huntington Beach. So I remember about 9:30, 10 o'clock at night, I'm driving into Huntington Beach and I noticed cars parked along the side of the road with water marks around the door handles. I finally get home, I'm cold, I'm tired, I forgot to have dinner, forgot to eat lunch. The phone rang. And it was Larry Holmes, the fire chief for Orange County. And he said, Supervisor Silva, he said, I have some very bad news for you. He said, we're going to be working all night in Leisure World. He said, we'll have to evacuate up to 2,500, perhaps even 3,500 residents from Leisure World. Would you like me to keep you informed tonight? And I said, no. I said, I'll be down there. And I remember the intersection over here was flooded. There was a little car floating out in the intersection. And after I was elected, I wanted to make sure that we've never have another flood like that that actually took out this building and the church across the street and a lot of the homes around here. We have an ongoing, continuous cleanup of the flood channel to make sure that it's always clean. So if we do have any kind of a storm, that water will be able to flow through there. And then I worked with your city officials, Leisure World officials, I see Mayor Brown up here. We worked many hours trying to make sure we had the money to retrofit the pumps so we wouldn't have another flood. Now, when one door closes, another door opens. And we had a door closed on this building, but it's nice to have a new door open where we have people that have vision for the future to meet the needs of the seniors that live here at Leisure World. And again, it's an honor to be your representative and to be here and sharing this joyous occasion. Thank you.
You know, we work with the county so closely. We also work with our city. And our city really indeed played a very important role in seeing to it that this project gets completed without any cost overruns and make sure it is safe and is built properly for our residents. This morning, we're very fortunate that we have the mayor of the city, Seal Beach. Before I introduce him, I want you to meet with some of his other staff and other council members who are here. We have the city manager, Keith Till. Keith, would you please stand for there? And we work so well with our police department, and you all know what a safe community you live in. I'm so honored to have Chief Sellers this morning. Sean Boyd, who is a other council member in the city of Seal Beach, is here. And I know there are many other city employees who've been involved with us. They are here this morning. But I do want to welcome to the podium now the mayor of city of Seal Beach, Mr. George Brown, who happens to be the president of the municipal association.
Thank you very much. On behalf of the city, I send you greetings and welcome to your new facility. Unfortunately, about two-thirds of the city will never really see this or know what a great thing we have here. But I do. I live here, and I'm looking forward to visiting it, but not as a patient if I can avoid it. But anyway, welcome very much, and it's been a long, long, hard-fought battle, but it's worth every bit of it. Thank you.
I know a lot of the Golden Rain Foundation directors are here and who have worked over the years on this project. I would like all of you to please, if you either stand up, if you're standing up, raise your hands and want to recognize all of you. All the Golden Rain Foundation President Board of Directors. Thank you for your help and assistance in this building. You know, when this project got started, we had to have someone who was going to design this building. And then we had to have someone from that design who's going to build this building. Well, there are a lot of people, you know, who worked on this project, but two people are here this morning. I just want you to meet with them. So if tomorrow something's wrong with it, you know, we'll be able to talk to them. Dan, would you please come here in the front for a minute? And Doug, I would like you to come here, please, both of you. No, keep your red t-shirt on, Dan. I want you to keep it on. But these two people, Dan Cash represents the contractors, Miles and Kelly, company who won the contract, and Doug Ely represents the architect design firm who designed this project. So if you find anything wrong, you know, if you just let me know, I always talk to them. Come here, Doug. During the construction to make sure all the plans were done properly. And Dan Cash is the guy, my hat's off to him. He has done a wonderful job. I want to remind him. Jerry Fury. Well, now comes the part of who's going to occupy this building and who's going to run this building for us. But we have our other partners with us, who partners not in ownership but in operation only, who will give us the rent for the building and also work with us. And they are here this morning. And I want to introduce some of those people with you, because those are some of the doctors who take care of you. Dr. Denmark, who is the medical director, is here. Dr. Denmark. Dr. Prakash Narayan is here. Many of you know he sits on the Leisure World Medical Advisory Board. And the person who is going to be responsible for running this facility, along with all of the staff, and this lady has been so helpful and has been literally a nervous wreck for the last year and a half, because she had to see to it that all the doctors remain happy in their trailers. Then she had to make sure that they all got moved in properly, and they all wanted different colors on the wall. They all want different desks, you know, and they all demand that they give it to her. I'm so proud of her performance. Diana Dahl of Leisure World Healthcare Center at Newsweek. Diana, would you please stand? And the gentleman who is responsible for financially making this a success, and who has indeed contributed tremendous amount of money for the design of this project and ongoing requirements that we had for this building, is a person who represents the Los Alamitos Medical Center and also the tenant corporation who is renting this facility from the Golden Rain Foundation. We're very fortunate to have the executive of that organization, Mr. Gus Valdespino. Gus, would you please stand? Would you like to say hello?
Thank you, Bill. The last time I faced this larger group, some of you are laughing already, it was October 17th, 1995, and Bill asked me to come to an open board meeting where we'd be discussing the new clinic. And he said it would be easy. All I had to do was state four or five reasons why we needed a new clinic and get off the stage. What he didn't tell me was that there was going to be about 300 people there who were very much opposed to the new clinic, and I would also be answering all of their questions. Needless to say, I vowed at that point probably never to address a group this size again at Leisure World. Nonetheless, I'm glad that 3 years later, I can stand here and be very proud of addressing all of you, and on behalf of Los Alamitos Medical Center, really feel very much excited for what we have accomplished here over the past 3 or 4 years. I would like to thank several people for their commitment, their support, and really for just patting on the back and telling us to hang in there. That's Mr. Narang. Thank you very much. The President of the Board, Mrs. Tuttle. Medical Committee, and Mr. Brown. There was one more person who kind of saw it through thick and thin with me, and that was Mrs. Burns, who was chairperson of the Medical Committee during those 2 years. Bill has made mention to our rental increase time and time again today, and I can stand here today and say I have never been happier and more excited about paying more rent for a facility in my business career. Thank you very much, and enjoy the new plan.
Well, I want to thank all of the staff of the Healthcare Center, Golden Rain Foundation staff, who have worked so hard with me to get this project realized, the contractor, the city official, the county. All of the individuals who have been involved in this project has been nothing but wonderful. But one group of people you recognize and you see them from far away, and I want to especially recognize those people here this morning, are those volunteers. In those little green jackets, you know, you see all these ladies and gentlemen? They are the greatest people of residents of New York. They are the ones who are going to take you in and show you around, and hopefully along with the staff of the healthcare center, if you care to see the building inside. It has been absolutely marvelous that their support as residents of this community, without any compensation, they want to make sure that your comfort and your safety and your easiness to come and get service at this healthcare center would be their paramount concern. I want to thank them very, very much, and all of you for your support and for your continued support of this project and many, many more projects that this community is going to build, because we are indeed looking forward to the year 2000, because I know all of you are going to be needing these services, and you need to work together so that we can keep Seal Beach Leisure World an affordable, but one of the best places to live in the world. We're going to formally open this building this morning, and we're going to have a little ribbon cutting ceremony. If you all please stay where you are, we're going to have Mayor George Brown, Supervisor Silva, Gus Valdespino, Diana Doyle, And Ms. Tuttle, of course, very important person. If you come forward, please. And Dr. Denmark, if you just come forward 1 second. Well, we're going to have Ms. Tuttle and Gus cut this ribbon, you know, and just wait. Is it really going to cut? No. Well, we're going to see how good this scissor is, you know. It's not, it won't do it, you know. This is really a ceremonial. I want you to know that officially, today we open this building for the resident of Seal Beach Leisure World to use. And here this morning at 10:30, November of 1998, Healthcare Center is open for business. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming. Thank you, guys. What we're gonna have is, we're gonna open the building, and just to give you briefly, that first group, and we want you to all stay around as long as you want. This entire week, we will have refreshment here. If you let your friends and neighbors come in and they want to see the healthcare center, we're going to go on this afternoon after 2 p.m. today. I want to thank all of you for coming here this morning. And let's go in there and see what this building is all about. Come on.
Conference room here.
Yeah.
I like to stay right here. All the goodies.
Taking any.
Turn around.
He turned around. That's all right. How about Mary?
No, I don't want my picture taken. Yeah. Too old.
Too late. Too late.
Hey man, look at that. Wait, I'm going to zoom in on that plate. Look at that.
When you look at me.
My name is Bill Narang. Today is November the 16th, 1998, and we are here in front of our new healthcare center building, which we had the opening ceremony this morning. I know many of our residents were not able to come this morning, so what we decided, thanks to the Video Producers Club, particularly Hal, who has taken the time to take with us the tour of this building and meet with some of the people. The first person I want you to meet is Diana Doyle. Diana is our healthcare center administrator, and she's the one who is responsible for
taking care of the day-to-day operation of our facility and making sure that each and every one of you who come to the healthcare center get services for as you need them. Diana, you want to say hello to everybody?
Hello, everybody. We're going to go on a tour now.
Well, this building here, which we opened up today, has some new additions and changes that the entry in front of the administration building is now one way, and parking lot is open for our residents to come and park. We have a drop-off and area where the Leisure World buses are going to come. Healthcare Center bus will come to go to the hospital, take the people if they need to go there. Ambulances are here, emergency vehicles are parked here. So now we're going to go through the main entrance. The main building has three entrances. And maybe Hal, you can show as we speak, you know, the first entrance to far right is going to be the community room, conference room. Then the second entrance where the pharmacy is that people can go in. And this is the third entrance with the giant balloon here that we're going to go in to the main entrance into the healthcare center. As we walk, Hal, into the building, we're going to have Diana Doyle with us. Oops. Who come in and help residents as they are coming in for service. And these are our healthcare volunteers, you know. This is the main entrance. As you come in, you get greeted by the volunteers, and also you can check in. Diana has provided the staff in front of the healthcare center. So we're gonna go. If you look to the left, Hal, you will see the pharmacy entrance is also from the lobby. On the right, if you turn your and show people how to check in. Hal, you want to walk in? This is where you see right now some residents are coming in and they are checking in and wait for your turn to be called. Okay. So this is our main lobby. This is where we are. Now we take you inside. Yeah, we go to the optometrist. Hal, picture of all the doctors, you know, physicians. That might give you a good view of it, you know. Okay, let's take you through the ophthalmology. Diana, why don't you talk a little bit about the ophthalmology, you know, let her know.
This is our ophthalmology department. We have full-time ophthalmologists. We have an ophthalmologist in here almost every day. This is the check-in counter if you come to see the doctor here. Right over here in this area, we have an optical dispensing shop. Yeah. Now we're going back into the clinical area where the doctors practice.
Hi, Doris.
Wow, who's that beautiful?
You
want to
look at this one?
Mm-hmm. I think this is a room, you know, you can see all the rooms are the same. Oh. Yeah. This gives you a lighted, you know.
That's nice. This is a typical exam room. All of the rooms are the same. You can see.
Okay, let's go back to the other
side.
Okay, the front gate. Then someone from the healthcare center, one of the employee of the healthcare center, brings you in to your appropriate physician that you need to visit with, and they bring you in here, and we're going to go through the area. But before we go there, the Golden Age Foundation has been provided with their own office in here, and that's where Golden Age Foundation volunteers, which assist us with the health lifeline systems and also provide people with wheelchairs, walkers, and so many other good services that they provide to the community. Healthcare Center has provided space for them inside this new Healthcare Center building. So what Diana is going to take you through the one of the main areas where the physicians are and how you get to see most of the work in the laboratory, you know. You might talk about the lab.
This area down here is the laboratory and x-ray area. We can go take a look at this. If you needed to have your blood drawn, this is where you would come to have your blood drawn in this area. And this area over here is the X-ray department. There's no one in there right now, so we can go in and take a look. So this is where you would come if you needed to have an X-ray taken.
Station, you know?
If you were coming to see one of the primary care physicians, you would be called back into this area. This is one of the nurses' stations. What we can do is go into an exam room. Let's go over this. All of the exam rooms are set up the same way. So this is a typical exam room where you would be seen by the physician.
Hello? Hi.
A total of four stations like this, two in the primary care and two in the specialist. So when you go inside the healthcare center, you will see four of these areas depending upon your need and who you need to see when you call in to make your appointments. We encourage you very much, you know, if you're coming to the healthcare center, please call in first. The telephone number is always publicized in the newspaper, you know, and make your appointment and do come at the time you're given the appointment. And they will assist you when you get here in a very professional way.
Who's that?
Dr. Hyder.
How are you?
What is this area?
This is another nursing station in the primary care area. And this is Pat Peterson, one of the RNs that works with the doctors here. The medical director of the healthcare center in his office.
That's my good man.
This is a new addition, something we didn't have before. It's a special procedures area where we'll be able to have much more room to do the procedures that the surgeons do in the healthcare center.
You got it marked?
Table. We have a new table and some new equipment in here.
Healthcare center. The design of the healthcare center was done keeping in mind all of the modern technologies for the year 2000. You know how we're looking at for the future, because there are many, many more residents who are always looking for services within this facility. And you can see that as you walk through. And I hope you come here, and when you come here, you will be able to see the convenience and how much care has been put into to provide you a service in a most comfortable way that can be given to you when you are visiting the healthcare center. And this is a clear example of that, what has been put into the planning and months and years of planning in building this building. So we're going to go through now, and we're going to show you some other areas of the healthcare center.
This area here is the specialist side. So if you needed to come and see the gynecologist or the orthopedist or any of our 25 specialists, you would come over to this side. And this is one of the two nursing stations in this area.
You know that in planning this building, a lot of thought was given into to make sure that the signage is proper, the lighting is proper, and how the people are going to be able to utilize the restroom around within the building. There are restrooms in the lobby, but in every area we have gone through, there are other additional restrooms for the use of the residents once they come into the inside of the building for service. And the signage and the doctor's offices as they are, they have created a system that they can have the doctors and the nurses follow very well, so they know what type of service you're looking for once you are in here. And you can hear the PA system. In the entire building, there's a complete PA system. We have taken into consideration all the city, county, state, federal regulations to meet for comfort, safety of the operation of this building. So we'll go through that, and we'll show you now where we're going to be. If you are visiting a specialist or you are visiting a regular physician, then you are taken care, and then how you are getting to go out, and you'll be finishing with your visits. Yeah, you want to do that?
I want to see Dr. Ginsburg. He's one of our surgeons. Show him.
Yeah. Okay. You want to talk about it? Go ahead and talk. He's looking at the photo. You can talk.
This is Dr. Ginsburg, one of the surgeons here at the medical center. He's in his office this afternoon waiting to see patients.
Okay.
Nursing station in the specialist area. This is one of our medical assistants, Abra, waiting to help you if you need to see the doctor this afternoon. All of our staff is here to help you and take care of you in any way we can.
With your visit with the physician, you are very professionally escorted to go out into the lobby area where you came from originally, and this is how we take you back. And you're, most of the time you do have someone escorting you in and out of the building. Once you are inside, when you're finished with your services, then you will be able to go into the lobby. Go ahead, Hal, you go ahead, take it. Why don't we go through the, this is where, you wanna, Diana, you wanna talk this in maybe? Just talk while he's taking the picture, you know. You can talk.
This is the checkout area where you would come after you had seen the doctor. And the receptionist here will help you make another appointment or schedule an appointment for a special test or whatever you need. I have seats here where you can wait while they take care of you. Where if you need to have any type of test done at the hospital at Los Alamitos Medical Center, Roberta can pre-register you here so you won't have to wait in line at the hospital. This is a very nice service because it saves you a lot of time if you need to go to the hospital. Also, if you're going to see the social worker, you would check in here.
In the healthcare center, we also took into consideration two of the most important areas that a lot of patients need care, and that is the therapy and also the cardiac rehab. We're going to walk through this area now so you will be able to see what a wonderful facility is there in case if you need it and how much care has been put into for your convenience and safety.
We have a nurse in here that has extensive experience in taking care of cardiac rehab patients. The treadmills, everything's set up in here.
Look at Diana's
dolphin. Let me open that so you can take a shot. Lovely. We have a nice fountain out here on the patio area for residents and staff to come and relax. Nice dolphins out there.
This also has capability, you know, from the back entrance. The clubhouse number 5 is here where the exercise facility is. The Golden Age Foundation office is. Video Producer Club is here. All of those groups are here. Once the construction is completed in the back of it and the buildings which are need to be taken out, they will be here. So a lot of people will be able to sit in here, walk through the ramp, and again, the convenience of providing accessibility has been designed very well for this building.
The art club is going to display their work on this wall here.
And then as we're walking, you know, now we're going to go into the regular rehab therapy room, you know, that has been designed for many of our residents, you know, that they may be using this service, and it is quite busy right now, so you might be able to see that. It's okay. Yeah, we can see the overall layout of the.
The basic starting position is this one for all the exercises. Now, the first one is a pelvic tilt. All you do is tilt your pelvis. This one.
Okay, now we'll take you to the administrative offices and where Diana Doyle is, and also the big community conference room we have in here for the use of the many of the residents who come in here to listen to the lectures and various other activities go on which are designed by Diana and her staff. You know, we publicize them in the newspaper when and if they are done in here. So we're going to go to that area.
Harold, call the operator, please. Harold.
Pretty room, Hal. We're going to be entering now, you know, where many of the lectures and other activities go on in way of Golden Rain Foundation and Healthcare Center have an advisory committee. And the advisory committee board meetings are held here. And other various medical-related talks, doctors or outside people who are invited by the healthcare center, they come into this room, and staff meetings are held here for the training of all of the staff of the healthcare center to make sure that they are trained very well to provide you with all of the services that you need to get from the healthcare center. Now from here, we're going to be able to go into the pharmacy, so we'll be able to show you how the pharmacy has been put together for you. Know, you know, that the partnership between Golden Age Foundation, the 24-hour emergency nursing, the Lifeline system, which has been so well put together, I get so much help from the healthcare center people. Hal, I want to share one thing with you, you know, that we have in this healthcare center, that the partnership between Golden Age Foundation and also with the Leisure World Healthcare Center and Golden Rain Foundation for providing 24-hour emergency nursing, the Lifeline for some of our residents who need it, and also 24 hours, someone is always here to assist our residents in case of an emergency. Mr. John Walton is a president for that organization for a while with the Golden Age Foundation, and now he's assisting us, also working with the Lifeline. He spends a lot of his time making sure that the residents are getting that service if they are given the permission by their physician to have the Lifeline service at a very, very affordable charge on a monthly basis. So this partnership is working very well. We want to take you in and introduce you, John Walton. John, how many Lifeline units you have now?
Approximately 500. I don't have the exact figure. I won't have that until later in the month. But we have about 500 in active service right now. We have some on standby reserve.
I understand you also have a lot of volunteers who come and help you to go install these Lifeline units into the residence apartment.
Oh, yes. We have quite a few. I can name them off. Just for the record, well, there's Danny Brucio, Al Levins.
But there are people in here that will assist you that in order to keep the cost down for the Lifeline system. And then Diana provides a lot of her staff to assist with it. As we go inside, you will see that her staff is working, which barely try to recover the cost to operate that thing as economically as possible for our residents.
Okay. We appreciate the help and assistance that Diana has been to us. Without her, we'd be lost.
Well, we're going to have Diana take us in, and so we can show you, you know, what is inside, okay? Let's, thank you, Mr. Walton.
Hi there.
Well.
Hi, well, here we come into Lifeline and Emergency Nursing. This is Bud Moldenauer. He is the coordinator of the Lifeline here at the Medical Center. You see the units in back of you here.
This is what the resident would have in their home if they need help, and this would be the button that they press. If they need help and can't get to the phone, they simply press this, and this box would then make a beeping noise, which this box also has a number called a subscriber number, and that will come in through the phone lines to our receivers, which are right here. These are called RC400s, or the central unit, and these are set up for around 500 of our residents, and they're monitored 24 hours a day, and we have the keys and all the medical information along with this, so when they need help, we have a whole set of information ready to get the emergency BCLS team out to the resident if the situation warrants.
Well, this I think you should answer your phone.
Yes, I should.
We want to make sure you get to work. And Hal, we want to let you know that the emergency nursing is here along with the Lifeline unit, you know, and they also provide a very valuable service to the community.
There's a nurse here 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, to help you should you ever need it. All you need to do is call the main center number, healthcare center number, which is 493-9581.
And Hal, on the unit for the Lifeline, it is only available if your physician gives you a prescription and says that you do need that service. So you must get your physician approval and authorization before you are able to get this unit. And because of the affordability and because it is contributed by the Golden Age Foundation and by Healthcare Center, the cost is very minimal for you to maintain a monthly service on this Lifeline unit. It is only for those people who really need it. Thank you.
From the backside on the
lobby, and how busy this healthcare center is, as people are coming in for getting some services within the community. And this is how active it is all the time inside the community. Now what we are doing is we are also standing in front of the pharmacy building, and the pharmacy building has two entrances. One, you can come from the outside, and you also can go from the main lobby. We'll just walk through it, and you see what a wonderful job they have done of putting the pharmacy together.
See? There's many gifts and cards. Little deli section over here. All of the home health care items that you might need, as well as Christmas gifts. You should come by and see the nice selection of merchandise they have for Christmas. Go back here and look at the pharmacist now. Probably want to take some of this. It's so pretty.
Stop. Focus on the, let's go to the focus of pharmacy, you know, not so much, you know. Let's go. The areas where you can consult with the pharmacist, and you can also ask, they answer your questions, you know. We're going to go where people bring in their prescriptions. And Diana, do you still do home delivery on the prescriptions, or we do?
Yes, we do home delivery on the prescriptions if you're unable to come in. You just need to tell the person when you called in your prescription that you needed it to be delivered.
And the other good thing about this healthcare center now you have is your doctors can send their prescription directly to the pharmacy. You don't have to bring it with you. When you come here, they tell you to go to the pharmacy. You will be able to pick up. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. Let's go up there, and Hal, you can see how people are getting their service at the pharmacy for medication. And we'll just let you observe it.
Maria, stay away. I just want to explain to you that Maria, stay away.
We want to just
go over this side. This is the pharmacy. The pharmacists are in the back filling the prescriptions. We have the pharmacy assistants and the receptionists that bag up the prescriptions for you. Over in this area is a consultation area where the pharmacist can sit down with you and talk to you about your medication. Let's go look at that over there. So they have this private area where you can have a consultation with the pharmacist at no charge if you're on a new medication or you have any questions about your medications.
You all these products here, huh? For medications, right? You can pick up yourself, right?
We have all the over-the-counter medications that you might need. You can pick them up right here. Home health care products in the back. We can order you anything that you need.
Let's go from the outside so we can see.
I've gone through the entire healthcare center, you know, just to give you a quick tour, but I'm sure there are going to be more things as we go along. The pharmacy, the healthcare center, the specialists, the primary care physicians, and the conference capability, and the lab work, and the cardiac rehab, your regular rehab that you need to go for. And then in the front of this building, you know, the Leisure World Healthcare Center bus comes here, the Golden Rain Foundation buses come here, They drop you here, and they will pick you up from here. What we wanted to also let you know that one of the good news for those people who are under the age of 65, who are not on Medicare. Diana, now I understand that you have started to introduce a program here for those people to get service in the healthcare center.
Yes, we have the Blue Cross Prudent Buyer PPO product available for residents under age 65. So now they'll be able to come here at the medical center if they have this insurance. Of course, you can come with whatever insurance you have or pay cash, or we do have contracts with several health plans. So just give us a call and we'll work with you if you want to come here to the medical center. And I hope you'll come by and see us anyway.
Well, welcome to our new facility now. And by the way, I want you to know how you recorded this morning, but let me reemphasize again one more time that this healthcare center building is owned by the residents of this community. There is no loan. This facility is entirely paid for by the Golden Rain Foundation for the use, benefit, and enjoyment of the residents of this community. I want to thank you, Hal, and your organization for providing us the opportunity to give a tour so those people who are not able to come and see this facility this morning in the rubber cutting ceremony. There is some construction going to be going on for the next 2 or 3 months. The project is not yet complete. It's a three-phase project. We are now entering into the third phase. We will keep you informed through our Golden Rain News. And I want to thank Diana and her staff for assisting us with everything. Diana, thank you very much, okay? We really appreciate
that.
Pleasure. Okay.